Welcome back to the Weekly News Roundup. Let's see what's in the bulletin for this week. Bengaluru-based Embassy Group, which was planning to acquire Indiabulls Realty arm, has now cancelled the same. The company has no immediate plans to increase its stakes in Indiabulls Real Estate Ltd from the current nearly 14%. The company's CMD Jitu Virwani said, "The company would remain invested in Indiabulls Real Estate," he added. As realty firms are going bankrupt one after another, banks might have then to bear the brunt. The struggle to raise funds is on the rise in the sector, except for commercial real estate in the office space. The rest of the sectors, including housing and other commercial projects such as malls and hotels, are witnessing a decline in demand, with inventories piling up by the day. Good news for delight, as people in the national capital breathe the cleanest air in 5 years for a day that falls immediately after the Sera. But as per the officials, the situation is likely to deteriorate in less than a week. Central Pollution Control Board data showed that on Wednesday, the city's overall air quality index was recorded at 173 compared to 326 last year. Embassy Group's WeWork India is all set to foray into the Noida market. The company has taken on lease over 3 lakh square feet office space to open 3 co-working centers comprising nearly 3,900 seats. The company has 26 operational co-working centers with 46,000 seating capacity. The Uttar Pradesh Real Estate Regulatory Authority has identified 22 projects where the builders missed deadlines to give ownership as stated in their affidavits in the court. A total of 15 promoters may face penalty of 5% of the total project cost. Under Section 63 of the RERA, if the replies are deemed to be inappropriate, then a penalty will be levied on them, said the authority. That was all for this week. We will be back next week. Until then, stay updated and stay away from the fake news.